battlefields.
Yeah, that's probably true. So we are going to start on Dreamland. Marshall really does like the stage, and most likely we're going to be seeing a longer match, but we'll see about that. Because right now, Pow Pow is being a very aggro Sonic. Alright.
Gotta play that guessing game.
I know.
Every time Sonic hits your shield, you gotta play a guessing game where he's going in order to punish him.
Mm-hmm. And what I still don't understand is being invulnerable, like on the rising part of your spin dash, like what the heck? Masahiro Samurai, please. Alright, yeah. So right now, Pow Pow has a little bit of a lead right there.
A little bit.
Recently, Pow Pow has been giving Marshall a lot of trouble, for sure. At least in these past couple constructs.
Yeah, he's doing way better.
Yes, most likely Pow Pow is going to be ranked number one in the state.
I would actually agree with that.
Yeah. Pow Pow had an extremely close set against me. You know, it was a 2-0 in his favor, but I was just going easy on him. He wasn't even playing Sonic.
No.
Yeah, I know. No, it was.
Oh, he was playing Mario.
Yeah, he was trying as Mario. I got a really stupid janky footstool KO on him, and I SD'd. So.
Oops.
So yeah, it wasn't the best match on either. Ooh, good back air. Marshall sneaks in with that, and that's gonna be a stock.
Couldn't make it.
I know. I really couldn't make it. All right. Good Diddy bread and butter combos right now. Ooh, good command grab.
That was smart.
Oh, I like that trap. Throws him off stage. Oh, Hypno Punch.
I always Hypno Smash is what I call it.
Hypno but Smash? Yeah. All right, never mind.
It's just like, okay, we just... it just sits there.
Sonic's animation of tripping is really funny. Yeah. He like falls over like, whoa. Yep. Marshall doing a really good job right now, weaving in and out. He has a percent lead, so he doesn't have to approach as much.
Papa's being a little too, what's the word for it? Like, not risky, but a little too aggressive, I guess. Maybe that's the word for it.
Okay. Oh, gets a little jab combo, but now he's off stage. Okay, now he's waiting. Yep, a lot of shielding against Sonic. That's kind of new. I never knew Sonic could do that. Ooh, up air! Oh! He looks like he went for a neutral air.
He brought it back. Papa's brought it back, too.
All right, now. Oh. We try to go for the up tilt. Gonna get punished for that. Alright, so.
The up air.
Oh, that up tilt hits through platform. I didn't know that. Is he gonna go for the Angel Cortez? Oh no.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, banana does smash.
He saw the roll.
Alright. Well, game one is gonna go to Marshall. So Marshall fighting his demons right now. Pow Pow looks.
They go back and forth a lot because like one tournament I'll see one win, the next tournament I'll see the other win. I mean, granted, I think Pow Pow's been more consistent because.
Yeah.
But that's like the only difference. But like still, Marshall can clench it out.
Like yeah, no matter what.
Battlefield probably for the lower ceiling.
Yeah, I could see that.
Because that's the difference between Dreamland and this. Dreamland, ironically, if you don't actually know Melee, actually has a lower ceiling in this game, not a higher one.
Yeah, which really doesn't make sense. It's very counterintuitive.
Well, there's a reason for that. It's because when they ported Dreamland over, they didn't do it well.
Oh, they did.
So that's why it has a huge ceiling. Because.
Oh, okay. So that's why it's just a lot bigger. It's kind of like kind of an accident.
Because when we actually look at Smash 64, Dreamland, yeah. It's not that big.
Oh, no, it's not at all. Smash 64, though, has maybe like, what, two legal stages?
One.
That's like Dreamland. And besides that, I know that they use basically a mod because there's no actual timer with them.
Oh, yeah.
And so there's matches that have gone like 10 minutes. And because one hit and you're done in that game.
So back to this. It looks like that was smart. Marsh, right. Not yet.
Yeah, not yet. Especially on Battlefield. It's not going to kill it just yet. All right. So right now, Marshall is still in the lead. But I'm sure Pow Pow is so used to that. People running up and shielding just because of that spin dash. So he got a nice and easy grab out of that.
Well, it's what Sonic Force is. You got to find a way to make him, like, actually...
Yep.
Got to find a way to actually hit him out of it.
Yep. Ooh, good down smash.
Trying to use the banana to cover ledge.
Ooh.
Got that good up smash.
Marshall doing really good, showing off a little bit of his perfect pivoting skills.
Yeah.
Did not get the platform cancel, I think, that he wanted. Point blank banana. I mean, peanut.
Only 3%, huh?
Yeah. I didn't know it didn't do that much. Well, I mean, I guess when Diddy has 15,000 other options to punish.
Yeah.
So I guess it really doesn't matter as much.
Right. The moment he throws his count, yep. Vanish. Because I didn't see him be out so long.
Yeah.
That was a good, that was a smart pivot. That was a glide toss. That was a pivot, item throw.
Was it a jump cancel on that also, or?
I'm not sure, but I know he pivoted in order to do it.
All right.
That gave him a little more distance.
Yeah. It's like as if Diddy didn't need another movement option, he has to jump cancel. And seeing the jab, something that you don't usually see in a lot of Diddy play. Most people just go for the fair plane.
Oh, he was trying to force.
Oh!
He interrupted up smash.
Yeah. He got some of the hitbox out, but I think it was still in the startup.
Yeah, good job taking it.
Ooh, nice
good
barrels.
Mix up. That's a good mix up.
Oh,
that's
nice.
That's it.
Yeah. And now Marshall's going to float to his death right there. Well, Marshall's up two games against Pow Pow, so...
And that one was Marshall. Very decidedly his favor.
Oh, yeah.
I'd say if Pow Pow wants to bring it back, I think what he's doing wrong is he's making a... I don't want to say he's being too aggressive, but he's making a lot of choices that Marshall's, like, covering, because he...
Yeah. All of his options seems like Marshall... I said Markle.
Marco Polo.
Yeah, Marco Polo. Yeah, a lot of his options that Pow Pow is choosing, He's getting red on him pretty well, and Banana's doing a good job of stopping him out. It seems like especially in that last game, he kind of hasn't gone with the normal flow that you usually see a Sonic player go with. Like in spin dash gets a punish, like normal combos that we're seeing, like Marshall is stopping immediately. Even like an up smash, he's already challenging. So I think Pow Pow does need to hold back just a little bit on the defensive side, but at the same time, I think he should still keep up that aggression. Because if you just let Marshall pull out bananas, he's gonna run away with it.
Yeah.
Lilat. Ooh.
This is a Pow Pow counterpicks his play. I noticed this. I'm not sure why he does, but he likes to counterpick the stage a lot.
Interesting.
Yeah, this is something I actually don't know from Sonic Mains, but I do know Pow Pow likes to pick the stage. If I were to guess, he likes the tilting of it. Because I know against JJ Rockets, he also counterpicked the stage at Endgame against him.
I know for sure. In this kind of stage. Oh, I completely lost my train of thought. I tried to take off the headphones just because to get my earphones. But yeah. Anyway, I know the platforms help a lot, especially if you're doing like a out of spin dash or top, like just a little like pop up a little bit on there.
Oh. Okay.
So I think the height's really good if he doesn't want to go too high with spin dash, and yeah. I think it's just the perfect height for him.
The perfect height.
Yeah. Not many people are huge Lilat fans, but you know.
I'm perfectly okay with the stage. A lot of people hate the stage.
Yeah.
I that was smart.
Oh, that was amazing. That Z drop banana into forward smash.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Marshall's kind of going off right now.
Yeah, Marshall's keeping that secure lead right now.
Ball gets a forward smash on him. I wish it was mine. Give it to Goodwill.
Yeah, just give it to Goodwill.
All right, well, he gets him off stage. Oh,
Hypno smash. No,
oh,
didn't kill him.
Why did that work?
Because when he up smashed, he hit the barrels and then it exploded.
Okay. So good stuff from Marshall, either being psychic or just going with just a crazy mix-up that Pow Pow wouldn't expect.
It's just, I think that he might have planned that, but I for some reason get the feeling I think that was kind of a oops, it just happened to work that way.
Yeah. I think he maybe tried to do a side B or something like that, and he just accidentally was going with that B, and he's like, well, I'm committed at this point. Oh, and gets him with that, sneaks up with that back here again. That's going to be a 30 and a handshake.